Welcome to Anole Alley. In this episode, we're going to look at the interesting mating behavior of the green anole. There are some who think animals feel nothing akin to real love for each other like humans do. Fact is, we are all animals driven by hormones and natural instincts. Anoles are reptiles. Reptiles aren't particularly known for their touchy-feeliness. But here, these two seem to be breaking all the rules. This is Spirit and his mate, dominant female, Yoshi. I think I'm starting to make poor Yoshi a little bit uncomfortable. I guess she's not in the mood for the paparazzi today. I don't blame her. I know how I would feel if I were trying to make out with my husband and someone kept sticking a camera in my face. So I'll leave the two lovebirds alone. This is Chili, the little female who's made her home inside the old broken air conditioner. It looks like Ziggy has his heart set on her. Aw, the look of love. It looks like even these tiny reptiles are capable of feeling some kind of emotion towards one another. Chili seems interested in Ziggy too, but she remains very cautious. This is just the first round of the games. She moves closer to Ziggy, but it seems that she's not yet ready to mate. One can't be too careful when considering the perfect mate. In the garden, anole love blooms as well. One of the females basks on top of the solar lantern, while Sirius, the garden's dominant male, watches over his green kingdom with pride. Sirius has several females in his group. Anoles are not monogamous, but they do have their favorites, as we will see. Each territory has its lizard king and queen, plus their court of subordinates. It's not long before Sirius picks his queen from the garden of beautiful females. And her name is Lyra. Named for that unusual tail, shaped like a lyre. What is a lyre, you might ask? Well, it's an ancient Greek musical instrument. It was created by the young god Hermes, constructed from a tortoise shell. As the mythological story goes on, the Greek god Zeus turned the lyre into a constellation of stars. The actual constellation is a small constellation listed by the early astronomer Ptolemy. It's recognized as one of the 88 modern constellations in modern astronomy today. Its principal star is Vega, one of the brightest stars in the sky. And here, Lyra is certainly a rising star. The two seal their bond with each other with a series of head bobs. The mating ritual goes on. The spring breeding season lasts throughout the end of May. Then the action will cool down so the males can rest and the females can go lay their eggs. I often get asked how how do you tell the male from the females? Well, it's pretty simple. When you're looking at mature adults, it can be a lot more difficult, however, when dealing with juveniles. But in general, females tend to be much smaller than males. They also have a predominant white stripe that looks somewhat like a zipper running down their back. But don't rely on this. As we'll see, males can share this characteristic as well. The males have huge, heavily muscled heads for lots of strength. Their snouts are longer than females, and it is their primary weapon when fighting with other males. There are many subtle differences between them. After a while, once you study them long enough, telling them apart becomes much easier. Males also have bigger dewlaps or throat pouches. Right now, Lyra is showing hers off to the neighboring female. I don't think she wants a third wheel around. Like the old adage states, three's a crowd. Meanwhile, in the backyard, Ziggy's been getting busy with Chili. After being rejected by her earlier, looks like this time he may have scored. But I think Sirius in the garden is still in the lead. So far this season, the mating games have gone off without a hitch. Some of these lizards will score many points. Hopefully, they will all become winners and carry their genes into the future. And for Anoles, the more means to carry your genes, the better. No, they are not faithful to their mates. But for Anoles and other species on this planet, that is how the mating games are played. And that is how they're played in the alley as well. The games will continue in round two. Thanks for watching.